Darth Vader's armor contained many mysteries and hidden gems. In the case of his right glove, this was meant literally. Within Vader's right glove housed an ancient Sith amulet constructed by the Sith Lord known as Lord Kaan, who Darth Bane would eventually overthrow to become the sole Dark Lord of the Sith. Similar to Darth Vader himself, Kaan had been a prodigy of the Jedi Order before defecting to the Sith and becoming their leader, forming the Brotherhood of Darkness that resolved to unite the Sith in loyalty under one dark side prophet. During his reign as the Dark Lord, Kaan constructed several Sith amulets that were designed to be indestructible. After his death, these amulets were rounded up and passed through the rule of two Sith Lords until they reached the vast Sith collection of Darth Sidious. After Vader was cut down on Mustafar, Palpatine ordered the Sith amulet be placed within Vader's right glove so that he may use it to protect himself, and that Vader would be suited to wield a lightsaber at all times, as the power of the amulet made it so the glove itself was indestructible. In addition to the amulet, Vader's glove was made using Mandalorian armor fiber, which held the glove together and made it possible for Vader to deflect blaster fire or even take glancing blows from lightsabers. When Vader's hand was cut from his wrist in Return of the Jedi due to the power of the amulet, the glove itself survived and would later be retrieved by Imperials who desired to gain power for themselves and ruled the Empire using the glove as a symbol of power. Quote, "No greater symbol of darkness was ever made than this glove, the gauntlet that once covered Darth Vader's right hand." Many believed that whoever held the glove of Darth Vader commanded his power, as it still housed an ancient Sith amulet. This was, however, only a rumor, as the only ability the amulet bestowed was being indestructible. Still though, many Imperials believed that they could use the glove and command the Force through it. Some even believed that Darth Vader drew all of his power from this glove. After wielding the glove for some time, the Imperials discovered the amulet within actually began to wear on their bodies, as they began to temporarily go blind, or in extreme cases, the glove would actually begin to erode the user's hand. This was mainly due to non-force sensitives being too close to the immense power of the dark side amulet for too long, as it began to take its toll on them. Only those powerful in the dark side of the Force, such as Darth Vader or Darth Sidious, could control the amulet for long periods of time. Eventually, the Imperials stopped using the glove entirely, as they were officially defeated by the New Republic. The ultimate fate of the right glove of Darth Vader was unknown, but what is known is that Vader used it with great success over his career as a Lord of the Sith. The glove allowed Vader to punch through walls without damage, and even catch lightsabers. The amulet made his glove utterly indestructible, but as seen in Return of the Jedi, it could be severed if Vader's whole hand went with it. Although it was never confirmed, it is believed that the amulet made by Kaan never exited Vader's glove after it was constructed into it, and that its presence within the glove was a total mystery except to Vader and Palpatine. What's significant about the amulet is its age, as it stemmed even before the time of Darth Bane. So what are your thoughts on Darth Vader's right glove and the Sith amulet that lay within it? Also, what do you find to be the most intriguing lesser-known fact about Darth Vader's armor and its many mysteries? And as another question, what is your favorite dark side artifact in the Star Wars universe? Mine would definitely have to be the Telos Holocron, as it held nearly all of the information of the Dark Lords of the Sith within it. That, or either the Book of the Sith that was held by Palpatine. Thank you so much for making it to the end of the video. If you enjoyed and want to help the channel out, be sure to hit the like button. If you would like to see more Star Wars explanation videos and stay up to date with all the Star Wars news from The Last Jedi to Star Wars Rebels, hit that subscribe button. Also, be sure to turn on notifications to see everything as soon as it comes out and to make sure that you become a living holocron today. If you would like to get in direct contact with me, follow me on Twitter, where we discuss all things Star Wars and debate with one another on the various topics concerning the universe. If you have any video ideas you want to see explored, leave them in the comments below the video with hashtag suggestion at the end of your comment so I can find it better. If you do end up leaving a suggestion, I really appreciate it and hope to one day make a full video dedicated to your question or suggested topic. Thanks again just for simply watching the video and your continued support on this Star Wars journey. May the Force be with you and have a great day.